Fofana has more from Freetown.
Grim, gloomy, grubby. These are some of the adjectives being used to describe the contents of the audit. It speaks of corruption and abuse of office on a grand scale by the government of former President Ernest Bai Koroma. The allegations are wide-ranging and mind-boggling. The massive sales of state assets to the former president and his acolytes. The awarding of phony and inflated contracts for goods and services. The issuance of diplomatic passports to purported housewives of members of the former ruling party. The government renting as offices houses belonging to government officials at inflated costs. State-owned banks having to write off as bad debts millions of dollars of loans given to officials of the former ruling party. Overpriced arms contracts. Inflated cost of roads, some of them priced at over $3 million per kilometer. Some concessions given to mining companies and exempted from any form of tax whatsoever. And entrenchment of mono-ethnic politics. The report also says the government's own shares at the Sierra Ruta Mining Company were sold when the miner was making huge profits to the former president and his cousin who was heading the company, and they both made a profit of over $100 million. The head of the transition team and now Chief Minister, Professor David Francis, looked peeved as he addressed the press conference. He gave me his impressions of their findings.
Sierra Leone was brought to near financial bankruptcy and the worst economic crisis since independence because of the activities, the poor governance of the former APC government. That is one. Secondly, and most importantly, that it was done in a way that represents a framework for what you would describe as an organized criminal racketeering enterprise responsible for the dysfunctional nature of the state itself.
What do you say to someone who says this could be a witch hunt?
Well, this is not about witch hunt. This is really to establish the basis for democratic accountability. We are recommending that a forensic audit be made through a special audit process to establish the key facts and a judge-led commission of inquiry, which should be independent and transparent. This is to ensure that this does not happen again in Sierra Leone.
He said that as a Sierra Leonean, he was ashamed of the things he saw during the audit, calling them disgraceful, egregious infractions. The report calls for a travel ban to be slammed on all those named in the report. Many of them have already left the country, with their extradition to be likely requested by the Commission of Inquiry to be set up. President Julius Madabio said he would act on the report as a matter of urgency.
I've just received a copy of the report, which has been long awaited. But I want to say this clearly, that we have to draw the line on corruption in this country. We have to fight corruption, and it is a fight that we must win. I know corruption is going to fight back, but we are on the better side of history. This is just the beginning. Corruption is at a level that can destroy this nation. I consider the level of corruption that we have met as a national security issue.
The allegations contained in the report with detailed figures and documents suggest corruption in Sierra Leone is not a kidney stone. It's a cancer. While not many here will be surprised at some of these allegations, most could be blown away by their scale and scope. The former president, Ernest Bai Koroma, who is out of the country, was not available for his reaction. His media officer, Ismail Sharif, told me that they had not yet seen the report and so could not respond.
Umaru Fofana reporting there from Freetown.